So, at the latest Microsoft Ignite 2021 event, Teams got a few updates. Let's summarize what they are. The most major one was probably Teams Connect, which is essentially a way to make it easier to share channels with anyone internally or externally, or absolutely anyone inside and outside of your organization. Now, this is very similar to something that Slack released called Slack Connect, similar names as well, allowing you to bring in people and collaborate in real time. Now, Teams want to be able to bring in people that don't have Teams as well. And this is an initiative that they're starting to bring that closer to home. Now, as you can imagine, they released a few views. They've been building on this over the last couple of months, particularly with the cinema view and these different like sort of auditorium views. But they knew they have a new one called Dynamic View, and it's coming later next month. And apparently it makes meetings feel more engaging, and you can adjust elements of the meetings. You can start with charts, chats, and video feeds as well inside of it. So it's much more of a customized view for those who are watching along at home or want to be able to modify how their Teams looks. And they've also improved the presenting modes as well with things like live reactions, PowerPoint live mode, which connects with your Microsoft PowerPoint experience, and a few more things as well. Now, they have made the sort of live events improvements a lot better. Now, you can use Teams to create interactive webinars for up to 1,000 people and attendees, and they also want the Teams live events also to be able to support up to 20,000 attendees later in the month. So they're really ramping up the ability to not just register people but organize them and be able to host that many people at once, which is crazy. Especially, I guess they're much more suitable for larger teams, but that's a good improvement. They're also improving the security of the actual meeting controls, which is good, and also they are aiming to release end-to-end encryption on one-to-one calls, which would help even better secure at-home calls. They've also improved a range of things in the mobile application with an updated visual look, including new headers, icons, and styling as well, and other features such as pin chats, new search experience, and expanded library of emojis, and lots more. So those features are coming to iOS first, followed by Android. So they're all that's new inside of Microsoft Teams. As you can imagine, they continue to evolve this. They actually have a pretty good update cycle with Teams, so it's great news to hear all these changes. So guys, please do make sure to subscribe if you're brand new. We've got some more MS Teams stuff coming in the near future. We'd love to be having you as a subscriber, so make sure you hit that now. Anyway guys, talk to you soon and cheerio. We'll be right back.